Everything inside me's changed. I was so much younger yesterday.
12. We're all here.
Is it just a Tuesday only?
It's just a Tuesday.
Woo!
Just all a right. Tuesday.
Welcome to the show. My name is Mo. That's Sam. That's Nick Ramos.
Hey.
631-0899. If you want to call us, get yourself on the show. We're on till what time? 9 a.m., kids. And should be a lot of fun. I'm ready to go. Are you guys ready?
So
we're
am
set.
I.
We're set. Let's
yeah?
go.
Sige. Small talk muna. Sleepo?
Nice lang.
Spare us.
Got a new
on.
Pillow.
Yeah? Oh, really? You did?
Yeah.
Does it have feathers inside, or is it just like a bunch of mishmash of soft stuff?
So you're actually curious about this new pillow. I thought
yes,
this was some
my
kind of metaphor or something.
Poke me with feather, and I hate it.
Mine does not poke me with anything. I got the answer. I think ano pang hotel.
Okay, you know what though? I'm really glad you got a new pillow because you've been having neck issues for a long time.
I know.
Finally, I'm happy for you. Okay, is that enough small talk?
That's great.
Yeah.
Let's take a break.
Yeah.
When we come back, nice. We have great topics for you guys to discuss. So please join us when we ask you to. Don't go away.
From halfway across the globe, it's Mo Twister.
In Manila, it's Samo and Nico Ramos.
Good times.
Mahal.
Welcome to the show. It is a Tuesday morning, the 17th of January. You're listening to Good Times here on Magic 89.9. My name is Mo. That's Sam. That
hey.
Is Nico Ramos.
Hey.
Phone number 631-0899. So, guys.
Yes.
Ano, you slept well ba?
Oh, my
okay.
God.
You know, I got some new pillows. I got a duvet now.
Did you have breakfast? Good. What did you have?
Not yet. Coffee. I'm having coffee right now. All right.
Excellent. Excellent. Oh, good.
You eat well? Did you eat well?
Oh, Nico, stop it. Well. Stop expressing yourselves, both of you.
How come I'm the one that gets yelled at?
Because you enable him. Okay.
Because you
no, but well, can't we talk about food. Our first topics all the time are about food. And Nico Ramos started the morning. He got into the booth and he's like, Mo, there's a new food park. Nanaman. And I'm like, well, I remember there was one in... You know, in Salcedo, when I lived there was kind of like a. Is it?
Oh, the Legazpi Market. Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah, it's kind of like a parking lot, and then people go out there and they have little food stalls and you go to. That's now everywhere, apparently. And Nico's not sure if he likes it or dislikes it.
I like the fact that more food is accessible to me now, and I don't always have to go fast food, being that, you know, I live alone and I have very limited cooking skills. I don't do well with variety. I don't do
it
well with too many choices.
It can be a little overwhelming.
Yeah, so I get overwhelmed sometimes.
Guys,
but I mean,
it's all food. Okay,
come on.
Yeah, no, please. Overwhelming. You're going to use the word overwhelming. The problem maybe with food parks, and then we're going to take your opinion on them. Do you like them? Do you like that they're
so
popping
many
up
of
now
them.
Everywhere? Yeah, 631-0899. We're talking food parks here. It's that with more food parks, it'll eventually be food courts, wherein people are just going to be, spending for their little stall, and then they're going to be selling whatever. It's not going to be... what I think is there should be, like, an exam, a test, some kind of trial first before you have to be good enough then to be put in the food park.
Well, in the case of Mercato...
Right,
yeah.
I know that they have, like, a audition of sorts where you have to present
right.
the product.
The
there's a panel,
for.
Yeah, and then
yep.
you have to taste it, and then they kind of judge. Okay, do we want this in the market or not?
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, I don't know how it works with other food parks though.
Yeah, because when
but see, the more food parks you have, then it's not going to be commercialized, and all of a sudden you're going to see just regular food there, and then all of a sudden you lose the novelty.
Well, I think the ones that maybe don't make the cut, you know, whatever that is, I think they'll probably die a natural death because they're just not very popular.
Yeah, because, you know, the thing with food parks is when you say food park, it's supposed to be, you know, the artisan food, you know, the one you don't see too often, but, you know, could quite possibly be the best burger in town or best chicken wings in town. And then, you know, like what we always do with these food trends is that we overdo it and then before you know it, you saturate the market. There's a little too much.
And then we're all sick of it.
The quality kind of drops down. And before you know it, you're just not into it anymore.
Eno says he saw a shawmaking inside a food park. And that, again,
is that like
an
a
example.
Is that like a commercialized big brand or something?
Probably. Right. So I think if you guys want these things to do well, the audition process is key. And then not open up one in every corner. But that's very hard to police.
I mean, I don't know. I'm just happy that there's so much variety. And you're right. They are kind of popping up everywhere right now. I mean, are people really complaining about this? That's what I thought. Yeah. Nobody is complaining about this.
Nico's complaining about it. I could see where his argument is going to be. That once you start making something kind of cool into... Okay, how about this question?
Yeah.
What's something that got big and still stayed cool?
Like a food trend?
See, it could be anything. Anything that expands and still holds its cool factor, what would that be? It doesn't have to be food. It could be anything. And you're going to be hard-pressed to find something because as things get bigger, they tend to be less cool.
Yeah,
because
I
when
suppose.
Nico said, you start to oversaturate. Too many people start getting involved.
That's
people
true.
People start going in for the wrong reasons. They start looking for things to, you know, they're looking to make money now instead of just share their abilities, their culinary skills.
The pioneers of pearl drinks, shawarma, and milk tea are all nodding in agreement with Mo.
Hey, milk tea's very much around still. Shawarma, still very popular.
People still eat shawarma? Really?
Oh, yeah.
Well, I do. But, I mean, it's lost. It's kind of...
I mean, the novelty's worn off, of course.
New kid on the block cool factor.
But, I mean, I think, you know, people are still really into it.
They had to change the name, right? Here, like, it can't be shawarma still, right?
It's still shawarma.
Don't they call it, like, one of those gyros or gyros?
They call it Persian. Thing?
It's all I've seen them now kind of all change their name into something else, but it's still all shawarma.
Sure, yeah, maybe that's one way you can go about it is just rebrand the whole thing.
Oh, now I know what I'm having for lunch.
What?
Shawarma. You say it too often to me. I'm just like, ooh, I want it.
But I don't know, Sam. Food parks, you like them, yes?
I'm all about them. I mean, I guess... There are different kinds out there, you know, maybe one will concentrate more on, you know, new food items, novelty items, and then the others are a bit more commercialized. But, you know, that's the beauty of it. Like, you can choose and then go in there and, you know, get whatever you want.
Do you trust them, though? Are they clean? Like, how do you know, though, as someone going there and you don't know what kind of kitchen they made it in or what kind of animals are walking around at the time?
Actually, the thing about the food park is, you know, it's all pretty straightforward. Like, the whole setup is right there. Diba?
Yeah, plus kasama talaga yun.
Yeah, you can't do, like, a very elaborate
setup. Like, you bite into the sandwich and you go, I can taste the Edsa in this. Yeah. Because food parks are literally, like, along the road sometimes. Sometimes they set up on the road, they close off a street.
Sarap ng C5 dip ko. It's like, you just... Can I borrow that Commonwealth ketchup, please? And then you just start putting it. But you're right. Isn't it like that's the thing about restaurants? Or they're controlled environments. You go out there to the food, you know, the food park, it might be a little nasty.
I pros and cons, I guess. You know, food park, as much as they're, you know, kind of mushrooming all over the place, they're still kind of a novelty. Yes, you don't get a professional, you know, squeaky clean setup, but you just take the good with the bad.
Wangs on Twitter has a really good point about food parks as well. He said, medyo mahal para sa quantity ng
tama.
Food.
That's true.
Also a legit concern.
Yes.
And you don't even know if it's good or not because there's no, like, you know, it's not a name brand.
No, it's,
so
yeah,
you're really taking a risk.
You're rolling the dice when it comes to a new brand, when it comes to food parks. I can understand why it's a little bit expensive. You know, obviously these are startup businesses who are saying that they're better than the mainstream products, so that maybe, like, I don't know, the raw materials are a little bit more expensive. They don't have that much, you know, financial...
Is that it? I mean, yeah, because this is true. I think generally, like, when you go into one of these food parks, the food is a little pricier. What is that about?
I think it's that. You know, I think it's that. I think they don't get a whole lot of foot traffic. Marami kang kalaban, obviously. There are like, what, 20 establishments in the park. I'm sure that the rent is sky high. There are a lot of expenses. You got to cover that somehow.
Okay, well, you're the one with the restaurant, so yeah.
All right, let's take one call and let's get out of here. I'm bored. Good morning.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. Okay, thank God, because I was bored. Can we get out of here now?
Let's get out of here.
Okay. Did you guys sleep well last night?
I got a new pillow. My neck is fine. Huh? Feels great, man.
Can I borrow? Can I take a nap in your house one day?
By all means. By all
Try
means.
Try this new pillow. Lovely. It is 6:28. Back after this. Don't go away.
From halfway across the globe, it's Mo Twister.
In Manila, it's Samo and Nico Ramos.
Good times.
Hey, happy 2017.
Yeah, you know what makes a happy 2017?
Oh, wait. I know this.
It's the Shakey's 2017 meal deal. Oh,
but yes. I can't move my feet. The more that I know you, the more I want to. Something inside me's changed. I was so much younger yesterday. I didn't know that I was starving till I tasted you. Don't need no butterflies when you give me the whole damn zoo. By the way, you do things to my body. I didn't know that I was starving till I tasted you. Faster emotional earthquake. Bring on disaster. You hit me head on, got me weak in my knees. Yeah, something inside me's changed. I was so much younger yesterday. Yeah. So much younger yesterday.
I'll tell you why in a second here. We just got to get it out of her. Sam has to get
Sam
it out of her system.
Is so mean.
No, what?
Yeah, Sam, whenever you're ready, Sam. Just whenever you're ready. I'll tell you what happened.
She's crying.
When Sam can mature and all 37 years of her can come to terms, I'll tell the audience what the hell you're laughing at.
Are you back with us, Miss O?
Oh, no.
Oh, my gosh. Okay, game.
Okay, so while that song was playing during the commercial break, it's a holiday, right? So here in the U.S., so a lot of the NBA games were on early, like hours and hours ago. Many of you guys may know this. You know, if you follow fantasy and all that stuff, you wake up early for your players and whatnot. There's a game going on right now, and Anthony Davis, one of the better, big men in the league, was on the ground. He got hurt again. And he's hurt, and his mouth is open in pain.
Sam.
And I go, you know, Nico, for the $144 million or thereabouts that Anthony Davis signed, you'd think he'd go to the dentist and fix his teeth, I said. And Sam's like, why? Is it really bad? I'm like, it's pretty bad. Why don't, can you Google Anthony Davis teeth and give it a look. The guy just signed $144 million the other year. So she goes and Googles Anthony Davis's teeth, and she just breaks down.
She sees it, like, it loads, and then she goes,
she goes, oh, my God.
Is this Photoshopped? It's not. Oh, in fairness to me, the picture that I was looking at was Photoshopped, okay? So, I mean,
right, but the non-Photoshopped version is still really bad.
Not far off.
Anthony Davis has very, very bad teeth. And I always wonder why certain celebrities who have all the money in the world seem to never get their teeth fixed.
He has so many teeth. It's so crowded in there.
He's got so many money.
He's so...
He's got so many teeth. It's so crowded in there.
It's so crowded.
You'd think, right, that with all that money, you'd be able to fix that. Now, we don't want to sound cruel on the show.
No.
We don't. We never do.
But it surpasses some line, right, of like, God damn it. Like, dude. Jeez, please.
You know, maybe
somebody fix that.
You know, nobody really likes going to the dentist, and some people more so. Maybe he's one of those.
Sam, if you know Anthony Davis, he's always injured. So
well,
he's always on the
floor. Yeah,
you don't. So he's always on the floor with his mouth open in pain.
And he's got time. It's not like the busy NBA schedule doesn't allow for him to go to the dentist. Dude,
yeah, he works 6 months a year.
You're out 20 games a year at least. Go to the dentist.
Right.
Like, go see somebody.
I mean, you know, I'm totally speculating here, obviously, but, you know, it's basketball. It's his living. He probably loves the game. Gets injured. Part of the territory. The teeth, though, I mean, it's...
I'm injured then.
You know, he doesn't have to, like, you know, he'll live. It's fine. And maybe he just doesn't want to go to the dentist.
So what you're saying, maybe as Philippine Espinoys, we kind of value straight teeth. You know, certain cultures don't. There's always that stereotype that the British don't really care too much about their teeth. Maybe he's just one of those guys like, okay, they're just teeth. Who cares? Yeah. My mouth is closed most of the time.
Because you're right. I mean, if he just signed a $144 million contract, clearly he has the money if he wanted to get it fixed. He doesn't want to.
He just wants to keep it uniform. His eyebrows kind of crowded in the middle.
I was like, never mind his teeth. Why doesn't he get his eyebrows fixed? But apparently this is a trademark of his or something.
The eyebrows are. And then when you saw the teeth, you were like, oh, my God. And you did this wow, a human. Like, this is a human? You know,
I did not see that.
But because it doesn't look – it looks placed differently, like what a human's mug would be like. So I don't know. Are there other celebrities out there that are really wealthy that just have really bad teeth? You'd think that they'd go get that done. Locally, too. Before we get into it, this wasn't our topic. I'm just laughing because Sam couldn't control herself before we got on air. Good morning. Woody Harrelson? Woody Harrelson? His bad teeth? I don't know. He's got a big gap between his teeth, right?
Oh, right. I think he might. Yeah. Yeah. Like Madonna has a big gap between her two front teeth.
But
yeah,
that might not be that bad a big of a deal. Let's take some calls. We got some calls on hold. And then we're getting to a real topic. I just want to get this out of the way. Good morning.
Hello. Our line one is weird.
Oh, there, Morgan Freeman.
Hi, good morning. Really?
Oh. Yeah. Morgan Freeman's got bad, bad teeth.
Hi.
Yeah, hello?
Good morning. This is Jason.
Hi, Jason. Hi.
Hey, Freddie Mercury.
He's dead.
He has a very big overbite, but he never got it fixed because he thought that was the reason why he had such a big rage was because of his overbite. So it was purposeful that he didn't get his teeth fixed, even if he had a lot of money. And he recognized that there was a problem, aesthetically, but because he thought that it was physiologically it was helping him sing. So he didn't get it fixed.
Oh, I didn't know that. That's fascinating.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thanks. Good times.
Bye. Good times.
Bye.
Boy Abunda has bad teeth, apparently, right? And
really?
I'm looking at his photos now, and they could use some work, I think. Mm. Next call?
Okay.
Morning? Mm. Huh?
Well, what are you trying to show me? Is that?
Morgan Freeman? This
you know,
is before
Anthony
though.
Anthony Davis.
This is before he apparently got it fixed.
This is before he got it fixed. It's not so bad.
Can you guys look at Boyabunda's teeth real quick before we get to the topic, please? I just want to make sure that I'm right on this one.
Yeah, Nico can get on it and show it to me.
All right, last call. We're out. Morning.
Hello.
Hello.
Hey.
Hey.
Hi.
Hi. Have you heard about what happened to Alan K.C. during a performance at Ibulaga?
No. What?
Ay, nahulog yung pustisa niya?
Nahulog yung pustisa niya while he was singing, I think, or talking. And then after that, it became big. Just pina permanent niya na para hindi na mahulog ulit on cam.
Recently lang po?
No, this was years ago. This was years and years and years ago.
Yeah.
Okay.
I got a thanks for the call, my dear.
Bye.
Someone
thank
on
you,
Twitter
bye-bye.
Here, Dawn says, Nico, you're a really good friend. You know, you have a really good friend. She's super hot, but she's got bad teeth. Yassi Pressman.
She does?
Not true.
You'll notice because she's, you know, she's got a good body on her, but, you know, that there's some teeth issues there with her as well. One last call.
I'm looking at her photo right now. Her teeth are perfect.
Good morning.
Morning.
Oh. Hi.
Hello?
Yes, actually, hindi talaga siya yung sasabihin ko, pero nung sinabi niya yung Yassi, medyo nag-agree ako ron, pero maganda talaga si Yassi. And yung sinabihin ko po talaga is si Julia Barreto. Medyo madilaw yung ngipin niya.
Julia Barreto teeth. Let me see what we're looking at here. The problem with it, it's yellow. There's nothing wrong with it, but it's just yellow.
Yes, tama. Pero, for example, sa movie house, syempre, malaki yung screen, pero mas maganda siguro kung ipaputi niya kasi bida siya ganyan, mga ganun.
Yeah. All right. Thank you, Mr. Perfect. Appreciate
Thank
it.
You.
Have a good day.
Bye.
Bye. Pogi natin, no? Okay. Can we move?
Yes.
Can you move on? Okay.
That wasn't the topic.
So, yeah, that was not the topic. Sorry. Sorry. Angelica Panginiban, bad teeth? Really? Twitter? Yeah.
No.
I don't know. Is it?
No.
Never noticed.
We would have noticed.
Didn't Megan Fox have one of those? Was it Megan Fox or?
Megan
or
Fox had a, like, parang.
Like a tooth growing on top of a tooth?
Yeah, may so pay, ganun.
Yeah.
Did she get it fixed, or does she still have it?
Yeah, no, it's fixed now.
Oh, okay.
James Harden's got bad teeth, Nico, you were saying.
Yeah. Oh, James Harden. Just somebody Google that. And then you go and Google James Harden feet and tell me which one's worse.
I'm scared.
Showbiz Bro says, James Harden's teeth, yeah, wow. They get hit. They hide well with a beard. But
why do you think he's...
Yeah.
Like wow. Anthony Davis levels?
Hindi naman. Okay. But, you know, not... They're rough. Showbiz Bro says Daniel Padilla. Daniel has really bad teeth.
Yeah?
Yay!
Really?
I don't know. Can we move on from the topic, please?
Hey,
go, I mean, so many answers here. We got to get... Okay, so anyway, here's another thing. Nico Ramos was saying off air that he wants us to maybe lead the way in... What was it, Nico? Trying to get man bags to be... Or purses... To be socially acceptable for men to carry.
I know.
Purses like women carry. Like
a merce.
The nice ones. Well, because the merce are still kind of... I think what Nico wants a full handbag.
I want a...
No, you don't, Nick.
I want a full satchel. Is that the correct bag term for it?
Yeah,
a
but
satchel. What in the
now? Why do? Because I carry bags. Like I'm a bag carrying guy, but I'm more on backpacks and then fanny pack. I do have a satchel. I don't use it as often, but I do like having bags around. You seem to want a handbag.
I want a more practical solution to it because the backpack is a hassle because you sweat. I mean, you know, ang init dito. So you sweat, and then all of a sudden the backpack is touching your back with a shirt and sweat. It's just horrible for me. If someone can make the belt bag, if someone can make everybody not make fun of me for wearing a belt bag or a fanny pack the way Mo does, that would be perfect.
But I wear it cool, though. Like
you don't.
Can you? How?
How dare you? I carry it well, Dick.
How?
You and I carry it across my back. I diagonal, Chewbacca style.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
He does.
It's beautiful.
Yeah.
I get so many compliments from strangers.
It's because he's got one of those fancy...
So this is a bigger version of a fanny pack, right?
It's not that much bigger. It's still really small. I mean, you can put a lot of things in it, and I just strap it on the side, like Chewbacca does. And it gets compliments, Nico. I think what Nico is... you tell me if I'm wrong. I think you want to compare bags the way girls do. Like, because guys can wear... The backpack is actually more practical than the girl's handbag. The handbag, you lose an arm. Now you only have one working arm when you Sam, you, I don't know how often you carry the handbag around, but you now lose a hand or an arm when you carry one around. The backpack, you don't lose any of those. It is more practical.
Yeah. I mean, a handbag you can sling over your shoulder, you'll still have two functioning arms, but, I mean, yeah, Nick, like, what exactly do you want
I think what Nico wants I think what Nico wants to happen is he wants us to do what you girls do, which is compare bags. I said that's the only thing that's different, I think, between us and females, is that we have backpacks, but we don't go up to your backpack and go, uy, ang cute naman ng backpack mo. We don't do those things.
Is that what you want?
There's a prestige a nice handbag.
I want things out of my pocket and off my hands, because this is what I have walking out of my house. I have car keys, I have house keys, I have a power bank, I have my phone, I have my wallet, I have a bottle of, I have a dispenser
coffee,
of water,
yeah,
I have a tumbler for coffee, sunglasses, earphones, and I find myself either stuffing my pockets or having something in both my hands, walking around the mall looking like an idiot.
This,
backpack.
I think, is a legitimate
that sounds like
concern
a
for men.
Mainit
nga kasi dito. You guys need a bag.
Here's the problem with the backpack. It's not yung mainit, Nico. I really disagree with you there. I think the backpack makes you look like a student, and it makes you look immature. And girls won't take you seriously when you're walking around with a backpack.
I think that's the problem.
Ako matangkad ako yung mga athlete.
Ew!
Pag naka-backpack ako, mo ikaw mo ang estudyante.
Shut up.
Pero at least mo ang bata.
So what Nico wants to happen, and we'll take calls in a second here regarding man bags. Nico wants a kind of like how the females value their bags, have it practical though, and just not make it backpack style. I don't think that'll ever go, Nico.
I don't know how you got that from what I said, but okay.
Because you said tumbler. Well, you can put a tumbler in a satchel. It's still too small.
But I mean, okay. It seems to me though that you guys manage. You do. I mean, your pockets are ridiculously overstuffed, but you manage. Do you think maybe the things that you carry around would change if you guys all acceptably could carry a bag?
Oh, I'd bring more stuff. Yeah, for sure.
You would?
Yeah.
What would Cat on Twitter says messenger bag, Nico. What's wrong with the messenger bag?
It's kind of like a satchel, right? Like a more casual version of a satchel.
I guess I gotta see a nice one.
You don't look like an executive, because when you have a messenger bag, you look like, you know,
messenger.
Yeah, messenger. You look like parang inuot.
Parang inautusan ka.
Yeah, it doesn't look CEO. I think is what your issue might be with it. Yes.
Yeah. How do the CEOs do it? Ah, may assistant sila.
No,
to carry all the stuff.
I'm. You know, listen, Nico. The reason why I'm answering for you is because I think you're lying to us. I do. I think what Nico wants is the prestige.
Okay, Mr. Bearer of my truth.
I think what you want is the prestige of the bag. Not really the practicality or the functionality of the bag. You just want it the way... Because I kind of am jealous that girls can have something like that that they can show off.
Okay. The backpack I own right now is the same backpack I've had for the last 3 years. I don't own anything expensive apart maybe from the occasional sneaker. How many bags do you have?
I think you might be the one that wants the
No. I mean, just told you I just wore a fanny bag across my chest every single day. It's
you're so much more a bag person than Nico.
Yeah, and
here.
How many bags do you own?
Yeah.
30.
Oh my gosh. That's more bags than I have.
Let's take some calls, Logical. Good morning. Morning.
I am so on board with what Nico is saying.
Anton, we miss you. We love you. Where have you been?
Happy New Year, buddy.
Happy New Year.
Thank you.
Finally,
so what do you want?
Call with the topic, yeah.
Yeah.
No, I know what Nico is saying. I used to have a man bag. My wife hated it. I threw it out. So walking around, I have a phone in one hand, yeah. I have a wallet in another hand. I get what you're saying, Nico.
Thank you, sir.
Did your man bag look like?
Some disposable cheapo that I'm not going to wear.
But
ever
style niya? Like, was it a messenger bag? Was it like
It's like a small messenger bag, like a man's purse or something.
So why, when Nico says he's envious of how females can carry a bag around, what size of bag now are the both of you want to carry?
No, it's what you want is the functionality that you don't have to lug around all these things that you have in your hand or in your backpack.
That is true.
And what's wrong with the backpack?
I agree again. Pinapawisan ka, di ba? Whenever you wear it, if you wear it the two straps, then pawis ka. If it's just one strap, then it falls over. So.
Oh, how are your teeth?
All right. I don't have 144 million.
That's right. Thanks, brother. We miss you.
Buddy.
We love you.
We missed you, Anton. Thank
Call
you.
Call us more.
Bye,
Happy
man.
New Year. Bye-bye.
Bye. I'm not convinced that that's the real reason. Take another call.
Okay, that's... Hi, good morning.
Morning.
Hello, good morning.
Hi.
Jason again.
Hey.
Hey, Jason.
I have the same problem as Nico because I'm gay, so I don't like girly things.
Right.
So,
yeah.
Normally when I used to have a girlfriend, I used to ask her to, like, can you carry my phone and my wallet in your bag? Because, like, she can carry a big handbag and still look stylish with it. So, when we broke up, like, I didn't know what to do with my things. So, like, I got a messenger bag, but then my tumbler can't fit inside. So I got, this small bag that can fit my phone. And instead of having a wallet, it has, like, loose pockets.
Yeah.
Because at least it looks a little more masculine. But still, it can't hold, like, all the other stuff, like hand sanitizers and things like that.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And my problem with backpacks is that, like, I have to stop to get my things. Like, I have to stop and put it down if I need something from inside. Instead of, like, having, like, for girls when they have their handbags, like, they can just, you know, lean a little bit and it can rest on their lap or something.
Right.
And they can just grab whatever. They don't have to stop. Or they can just open their arm a little and they can grab whatever inside. But you can't do that with a backpack. Messenger bags are a little limiting in movement. If it's a little bigger, it kind of, like, gets in the way when you're walking. So, you know, bag problem.
I have a question. Are you a butchier lesbian?
Yes, I am.
So you can do a sling bag because the sling will go right in between your boobs, yes? And then you don't want to highlight that.
It's terribly
annoying,
yes.
Right. What do you do for a bra?
What?
Sports bra.
No, really. What do you do for a bra? Do you wear sports bra? Do you wear regular bra? No bra? Sports bras.
Sports bra.
Why do you ask that?
Because the sling bag is really cool. Like, I think that's one that is the answer to maybe some of your problems. The only problem, though, because she's lesbian, I worry that the sling bag will just kind of highlight her boobs, which she does not want.
Yeah, that does happen. So, if it's a shoulder bag, I wear it over, like, one shoulder, not across my chest.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because it gets annoying. Okay. Yeah.
All right. Okay. Hey, by the way, if you want to, I mean, what is a lesbian doing with hand sanitizer? Get rid of that stuff, man. Come on. What do you think? Let's go. You're butchy. I need hand sanitizer.
Come on, man. I need
germs don't discriminate.
That's for pusses. Come on, man. Man it up a bit. You don't need that stuff. Get rid of that.
Come on.
Thanks for the call. Thanks for calling.
Thank you, Jason.
Good morning. Bye-bye.
Thanks. Bye. I was sold. It was like, yeah, I'm gay, man. I'm lesbian. I'm butch. And then I need something for my hand sanitizer. I'm like, ew. You gotta man up. Just wipe it on your jeans. Next call. Good morning.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Yeah. I'll go more on the messenger bag. The sling bags, actually.
Yeah, I think
the backpacks, kasi, it's very functional, okay? But, like what you just said, no? What do you put inside the bag? Cell phone, wallet, power bank,
What do you call it?
Alcohol.
Oh,
alcohol. 10 or less items inside.
Are you lesbian also?
I'm sorry, what?
It's 10 less things inside a big backpack, diba? It's just perfect. You could just put all your personal stuff. Easy to take out, diba? Because they have the signature brands now. Because they have the urban brands, diba? So you get to choose which side, eh? Let's say Mo was telling na... What do you call this on the bags? what's this, na we get to show like what women do, yung the brands.
Mm-hmm.
We have that right now, diba? Yung mga expensive brand na mga sling bags. If you are more on the functionality, there's also the functional ones. So
yeah, but girls have leather, and if we wear leather, we're dead. Like,
why?
That's just the you can't wear a leather backpack as a guy. You should get beat up.
Oh, a leather backpack.
Yeah.
Yeah, but guys who wear leather bags, it's very difficult to pull it off. Not everybody can do it, and that's the only problem with that one. But good call, man. Thanks for the call. We appreciate
Thank
it.
You.
Thank you.
Okay.
Wow, you know, now that I'm hearing what you guys have in your bags, I'm feeling like it's a little bit more ma'arte than maybe what females have. Like, look at Rancho Guy here says, I have a cares bag, two phones, power bank, charger, wallet, cologne, taser, very manly.
Taser?
A retractable baton. I'm with you there.
What?
Sanitizer and powder.
Powder.
The powder is next to the taser, which is next to the baton, and then there's a powder.
Oh, man.
Imagine if he got into a fight, reached into his bag, pulled out the wrong thing.
Baby powder.
Yeah, thought it was a taser, baby powder.
Hilarious.
Well,
you
right,
can kind of like, you know,
yeah,
throw it to their face or something.
Maybe one last one and we'll get out of here. Good morning.
Hello. Radio off, please.
Hello.
Thanks. Hi.
Not really a bag person. I resort to, tactical pants with lots of pockets. Mm. They really suffice.
Like cargo shorts or something.
Yeah, those.
But if I have to bring a bag, like if I have to lug around the laptop or some kind of equipment, then I would still go with what do you call that? Messenger bag or whatever, the bag that you strap across your chest.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. No,
that
this
works.
Is a dude here.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. You're right. Yeah, thanks for the call, man.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
That is a man.
Should I ask him if he carries hand sanitizer?
The wipes long.
Wipes. I have wipes. I carry wipes.
You carry wipes, don't you?
Yeah. Cause my,
you're kids.
Yeah. Well, no. I mean, aside from the kids, even without the kids, I carry wipes. What if
I don't think that's girlier than a hand sanitizer?
No, because the sanitizer, that's just, you know, it's like, I'm getting germs. You like, anong gagawin ko kapag tatae ko sa labas? Anong gagawin?
Hey, yo, like, wipes naman is like what? Hand sanitizer in tissue form.
For tae lang.
Ano yung sinusulatan mo yung wipes mo for tae lang?
No, but
hindi siya naglalakad sa sidewalk tapos nagwa-wipes dahil, oh my God, humawa ako sa madumi.
I don't wash my hands. I don't go to the, when I go to the CR and I urinate, I don't wash my hands and then go out. I just go out. Like a man. Pero kung kailangan tumae, kailangan talaga.
Glad may wipes.
I wash my hands before a meal.
Baby wipes.
Yeah, that stuff.
Baby wipes.
Yeah. There's a brand. It's Porta Elan. You just go and it's 7 o'clock here on this Tuesday morning. We'll take a break. When we come back, we have more of the show. Don't go away.
From halfway across the globe, it's Mo Twister.
In Manila, it's Samo and Nico Ramos.
Good times.
Are you ready to move up to a new TV experience? Say hello to the new Signal Fox Plan 390. Enjoy all the best from Fox.
Okay, good. Okay.
We're fine. Yeah. Hour number two of our show, 631-0899. That's our phone number. Well, I'm looking at our topic list today, and I feel like we are just medyo, I don't know, it started off with, grabe, there's like so many food parks. Oh. Then, guys, we need bags. Now we have one here that's, I don't know. Well, before we get to it, you get an announcement, though.
Yes, I do. I mean, I just wanted to tell everybody about...
Thank you, Sam.
Mm-hmm.
Back on the show here. Nico, you good?
Good, good, good.
Yeah, okay. All right, just check.
This needs to stop.
I want to talk about Yaya real quick.
What about Yaya?
I want to talk
well,
Yaya real quick.
You don't have a Yaya, right?
I don't. Okay, I don't have a yaya. I didn't have a yaya growing up either. Many of you guys do. I don't employ a yaya for my kids. I do all that myself. I enjoy it. It's good. It's a good feeling. It's driving me crazy when I work right now. Like you guys know this. The listeners don't, but Sam and Nico do that. During the commercial break, I have to run out and save my children from near death.
You are the yaya.
Yeah, I'm the yaya. And I want to be a part of their lives and do this for a really long time. I wonder how many of you people out there have yayas until a certain age? Like, what's too old to have a yaya? Well, who's the oldest person you know that has a yaya? 631-0899. Can you give us a call? What's too old? Six?
Six?
Yeah, like
six?
I mean, I have a seven-year-old son. If he had a uniformed assistant walking around,
he's
I
too
kick
old.
Him in the face.
He's too old.
Yeah, he's seven. So what, six? Is six the oldest you can carry a yaya around? Five?
Five is kinder.
Yeah.
Pwede pa? Pwede pa?
Baka pwede pa.
Hmm.
Yeah, six.
Kung grade one ka, tapos may yaya ka, there's an issue there, right?
Issue is a strong word.
I'm with you at six. I want to, unless I get talked out of it, six seems like a good place to start.
Our lines are full. The question is, what's too old for yaya and or who's oldest, the oldest person yes. you know that has a yaya? And maybe that'll change our answer.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, according to Twitter, Sharon Cuneta still has a yaya.
I was going to ask that. Does Sharon Cuneta, does she still have a yaya? So I guess she does, huh?
Susie of our station still has a yaya. Yes, Nico?
They have a yaya in their home.
Parang, yeah, that's the thing, right? Like, I mean, these yayas, they start out when you're a baby, and then, you know, your parents just keep employing them
sure.
past, you know, like when you're grown and stuff, and then they just kind of become part of the family, and then you just keep calling her yaya.
That's fine. Yeah, okay, that's fine. The term is fine. I'm talking about more just the action. Like, does Susie's yaya follow her around? Does she's like, yaya, condom. And then, you know, like, is she...
Oi! 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 Easy!
It's Susie.
Easy!
Yaya, condom, please. Like, okay, we can all still call her yaya, yaya, like we call Lola, Lola, even though, you know, whatever. But to have one follow you around still, what's too old? And who's the oldest person you know?
In all fairness to her, and, you know, I hang around with her probably as much as I hang out with anybody. I've never seen her yaya outside of their house.
Mm.
Okay, so she doesn't have a yaya.
Yeah, anymore. Yeah, yeah.
They just okay. Yeah, Nico yeah, here yeah. on Twitter says, I have a schoolmate. And we'll get to your calls in a sec. He was 15 years old, same as Christian Lim. Love you, buddy, he said. But had a yaya at 15 years old while they 15? Were at school at Shekinah Glory Christian Academy.
That's second, third year high school.
Yep. Yeah, yeah. Lines are full. Let's get to them. 631-0899. What's too old for a yaya and you? Who's the oldest person you know that has one? Good morning.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi. This hey. Is Lori.
Hi, Lori.
Hi, Lori. Good morning.
Hi. Sorry, I can't hear you well.
Yeah, hello? I think our line one's a little messy. That's line one, right, Sam?
Yeah, yeah.
Because I
can
hear
yeah.
the messed up. Yeah.
Okay.
Bear with us.
Can
it's
I
our fault.
Go on?
Go, go,
please.
Go.
Go ahead.
Okay. Okay, I know somebody who lives in our building, and this is from the yaya herself. She's already married, and she's got children, but she has a yaya. Whenever she goes to the bathroom and she has to take a bath, the yaya has to stay there
That's
to give
true.
Her a bath, rub her back.
No!
No, 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 no.
Lori.
Untrue.
We rarely tolerate liars on our show, but thanks for the effort.
I'm not kidding. I swear I'm not kidding. Also,
she has to wash her back?
Yes. And also, when she has to, when she has her period, the yaya has to stay there. So that
I was going to say this as a joke. What do you think? She has to do the period work, too? It's
what do
true.
You mean? Wait, well, what does she have to do?
She has to hang around, stay outside, and then when she has to ask for the napkin, the yaya has to give her the napkin.
You're
and put
joking.
It on?
Okay.
And put
I don't
it on.
Know. I don't know. I don't know if it gets to that. But bye.
Oh my god. How old is this girl? You said she's married and kids. Like what, 30s, 40s?
Yeah, she's married and she's got kids. I'm not going to say anymore.
Yeah, yeah, no, I get it. It's fine.
Wow.
Well, you don't have to give like, you don't have to give him personal info, but I just
age.
More want to kind of No, like is she your friend?
Not really. And I
not really.
Swear, I just heard it from the AI. I don't know this personally.
Okay.
All right.
Okay. No, because I was going to say, how do you hang out with this girl? Like, isn't that a little weird?
No.
Okay.
No.
All right. I got it. Thank you. Great call, Lori.
Thanks,
appreciate
Lori.
It.
Bye bye.
Ooh, man.
Wow.
Okay. You know, I thought the soaping my back part was really excess, but the Yaya, my regular napkin, please.
Yaya, can you hand me my regular pad, please?
Thank God you girls don't use the tampons. Imagine if that was... Yaya, tanggalin mo yung tampon ko.
Easy. Wow, you got on a roll real quick.
No, but listen, it's outrageous, and I wouldn't... I didn't anticipate it to be true. All of a sudden, now we have... These people are really doing it.
This is totally changing the playing field here.
All right, let's go. Let's go. More calls. Morning.
Good morning. Hello?
Hello?
Hi.
Pass the phone, Yaya. It's my turn. Hi, who's this?
This is Abigail.
Hi, Abigail.
Hi, Abigail. What's up?
Yeah, totally outrageous, the previous caller about that person.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
I do know people who have had yayas until they were high school and got married, and they became the yayas of their children and were, like, literally part of the family.
Yeah, yeah.
Huh.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, but when you say yaya till high school, meaning they were still followed around?
In school, like the baon and the ano, and then like punas after coming from the classroom, kasi hindi pa naman kung the classroom
start. What
part.
The hell?
Yeah, like you make level beam to at the back of your ano, blouse.
Beam po at the back of your blouse. Beam po at the back of your blouse. BBB.
You mean your classmates were in...
I've seen people na ganyan.
What the...
Yeah. These are Catholic private schools.
Man, I did not grow up rich enough to know these people.
Well, anyway, on your question, like, how old is, like, having a yaya in tow? If it's in the mall, like, acceptable for me is like if the youngest is three.
Three.
Okay.
Three. Because by four they're walking, you can eat whatever you guys eat in the restaurant. You don't have to make timpla meals, you don't have to make my own special cookies, whatever, diba? But for traveling, like if you're going to the beach and you have small kids and you want as a parent to enjoy, then maybe until six. Because they don't wipe their own butts. And it's kind of stressful na may tataing bata. And then, oh my God.
Thank you.
So shall you were for the first 80% of this call. You make the timpla, the milk, and then tapos tataing sila.
But then, my acceptable age is three in the mall, okay? Acceptable age to bring yaya when you're out of town, let's you go to the beach or you're out of the country, like Hong Kong, ganun. Baka hanggang five or six. By that time, tinuruan mo na yung anak mo magpunas ng puwet, di ba?
Yeah.
They can take care of themselves. They can take a bath. They can do whatever. And then you can enjoy also the vacation.
This sounds reasonable to me, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Three and six.
Yeah.
Okay, fine. Sure.
Or 16, and you have to, please put Bimpo at the back because I'm Taoist all over. Yeah, that's medyo over lang talaga.
All right.
Thanks, love.
Thank
You're the
you.
Best.
Bye.
See you guys. Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Okay, I don't know. Okay, so remember the first caller was outrageous, and we were like, oh my God, what's going on in this world? And she's like, she's in the bathroom and all that. Okay, fine. She's in her house. She's taking a bath. She needs the yaya to come in there to change her pad, whatever. Fine. Crazy. Okay. But in high school, for you to have a yaya to walk around in between classes, wiping off food from your dress or all of that in high school, I don't know. I think that's even worse.
How is the yaya even allowed in school?
Well, these richy-rich schools allow the yaya to hang around because these kids cannot, they'd melt if they didn't have a yaya.
Really? Really schools do this?
I would imagine it. Of course, when you're paying as much as they're paying, yeah, probably.
What?
She said it.
Whoa,
we didn't
wait,
ask what
whoa,
school.
Whoa,
That's
wait,
our problem. We should
wait,
ask
so school. You're saying that the high school kid with the yaya who follows her around is worse?
Oh, yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Because the yaya in the first call was like, okay, she's at home. Yeah, I understood that yaya probably followed her around as well. But when you're in high school, and the yaya is in the school premises with you, and after you have lunch and you're on your way back to class, she's wiping down your hands and making sure your dress is intact and all of that stuff. F you very much, double middle finger.
Yeah, if your parents had to formally contact the school to provide the identification of your yaya and say, can you please give her a gate pass so she may be in school premises while my
attached
son
to the
or
hip
daughter,
of my child,
yes, is in this school, so that in between classes and during breaks, the yaya can put a bimpo at the back of the blouse.
Okay, I think this is unanimous. Yes. Yes.
And yet, all of a sudden, I think I like the EJK on this, this one.
DMF, double middle finger.
Next call, 631-0899. What's two old? And you know who carried one. Good morning.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
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 What do you got?
This is Chris.
Hi,
Chris. Go ahead, Chris.
Yeah, I think the perfect age na pwede na silang iwanan ng yaya is if they can prepare their food themselves.
Prepare.
That's
I
still
mean,
pretty old.
Like Nico can't prepare his food here.
I'm 27.
So, I mean,
I need a yaya.
What do you mean?
No,
I couldn't prepare my own meal for a while. You mean eat? They can eat with. They know how to use a utensil.
Mine, we don't have a yaya for my kid. He's 8, but, siempre, if we have work, we need to still to leave him, in someone's house,
That's different. That's like more like babysitter. We're talking about like your child has an assistant.
But
that's different.
Yeah, I guess.
So
I
your child is 8. Mm-hmm. When did you get rid of the yaya?
Like 5.
5.
But if we don't have my grandma, that's where the problem comes. Because now panggabi kami pareha, so walang maiiwan kay baby.
Okay. But does your child if kung walang lola right around, would your child have a yaya while your son is in grade 1? No, in school.
No, of course not. I mean,
yeah, okay, then you're babysitter. You're talking about babysitter.
Yeah.
You're fine. You're normal.
Yeah.
You're normal.
With regards to the question na kung may kakilala o may cousin, he's now 18. And Ayaya still follows him. And when we
did
go to malls, sorry.
Go ahead.
Yeah, when we go to malls, family dinner, papakuha pa siya ng mga spaghetti, yung mga gano'n, nakakaasar lang.
Like, Ayaya, kuha mo ko ng spaghetti?
Yeah. Hindi siya makakuha ng sarili niya, nakakainis. 18 years old na siya, and he goes to a very good school pa naman, so.
Yeah, what school? I want to know. What school? No, really.
Blue one.
No, you didn't say his name.
The blue one. Yeah.
Is the yaya in the school during class hours or nag-aabang?
Actually, what happens is hindi siya marunong mag-commute. So, kailangan talaga isusundin siya ni yaya and the driver. And then, ang pinaka-annoying lang talaga is when we go to mall every week, talagang kailangan ikukuha siya ng food ng
knee to the face.
Yaya, can you cut my hot dog in my,
like
head,
that,
my
yeah,
spaghetti?
Really?
Is that really? Wow.
Literally, like that, yeah.
Wow.
And this is your cousin?
Yeah, this is my cousin. And to think
how much older are you?
We're 14 years apart, so.
You could still beat him up.
Yeah. Yeah, what you do is you join your hands behind his head and then knee to the face.
Yeah. Anyway. Yeah,
clean the blood.
About it.
Yeah. Okay. Thanks.
Thank you.
Good times.
Bye. Bye.
Ew. Ew.
My God.
18-year-old man.
I hate brats.
We already, though, judged him as a dick, right? What if he just doesn't know because it's his parents' fault?
No, totally.
Right? We already judged him as an ass. What if he's a really nice guy? He just didn't know because his parents never...
I mean, because obviously it's the parents that's paying for the yaya to follow him around.
Also, at 18 years old, though, you see that all of your other 18-year-old friends do not have a person putting bimpo at the back of your blouse.
It's the spaghetti, though. It's my
spaghetti. Specific.
Okay, I get the towel behind the back because I can't reach that far. Or maybe I'm too fat. Whatever. But the spaghetti. Oh, no.
Spaghetti.
Tapos, he's in university, right? So he goes to Ateneo, right? I get it. Rich school, you know, you get a driver. But the driver has to have the yaya there also.
And why is he commuting my driver naman pala?
No, he can't commute. That's why there's a need for the driver.
No, he doesn't know how to commute. So he needs a staff to pick him up.
Ew. Yeah, I mean, then fine. Then have the driver go. Like, why does the yaya
exactly.
have to be there?
Right.
Like, why does the yaya have to be
no,
there?
No, no, no. So the yaya will stand at the exit.
Nag-aabang siya.
Para sabihin kung saan nakapark yung driver.
Wow. In the world, cell phone ain't enough, huh?
Knee to the face, I'm telling you.
Good God. Sorry, we were a poor country, right? Is that what I heard?
Yeah.
Okay, just checking. Just checking if we're still poor, are we? We are, right? Okay. Next
last
call.
Check,
good morning.
Yes. Hi, good morning.
Yeah. Hello?
Hi.
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 Can you tell Yaya to turn off the radio, please?
No.
No. Yeah. Okay. Hate brats. What?
Hello?
How can I help you, dear?
Hello?
I'm kidding. Just turn off your radio, please, so we can all survive this call.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. What do you got?
Sa amin, yung mga ipamangkin ko and yung daughter ko, I think yung daughter ko, last na kayaya was 7.
Okay.
Alright.
Tapos yung ipamangkin ko, I guess, she was like 14 that time.
Mm.
But then, yung pita use lang para dun sa mga yaya, o dun sa kasama sa bahay, was to look after them, kunyari pag mag-mall, o yung parents, may pupuntahan na iba, may gagawin, may ibang errand, may mag-look after dun sa mga bata.
Again, it's like a babysitting capacity.
Babysitter.
Yeah.
Tapos pag
yeah,
well,
what
naman,
we're looking for is like your children have a staff assigned to them, assistants. That's the part I think we're looking for here. Not babysitters.
Well, yung daughter ko, meron siyang sariling yaya. Meron siya para mag-fix ng mga gamit niya. Yeah, yun.
At school?
Yung anak ko, meron siya talagang sariling yaya. Tapos yung kanyang mga cousins is wala. Because she's the youngest.
Is the yaya in the school with your daughter?
Or sa bahay?
Yun, never nangyari yun. Never naman nangyari na papunta, may yaya na mag-stay pa sa school.
Sa bahay lang.
Sa bahay lang. Or kuya mag-mall.
Okay.
Pero 7. All right. 7 years old. Parents.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, okay.
Yeah,
okay.
Not bad.
Little old, but fine. Mm. Fine. Okay, thank you. Appreciate
bye.
It.
Bye-bye. Thank
bye.
You.
What an awful call. I was thinking maybe, like, she doesn't rely on the yaya except when it comes to, like, in school, she needs her bag organized or something like that. The yaya jumps in, which would make me throw up still.
Should have asked her how long she plans to keep her around. But whatever.
Yeah. Actually, I want to meet these people who've had yayas since they're to like, their 18, 17. I feel like I can exploit them for money.
You know, it's also, you know, I think Nico touched on this earlier. You get to a certain age, and then you realize none of your friends have this. And so, you know, you just want to be like everyone else. You don't want to be teased for having a yaya. Like, you would think they would be like, okay, mom, this is weird. I don't want the yaya following me around.
Okay. So let me try to then throw out a possible explanation. I have no idea because we don't live this. But so, looking around, seeing your friends not having a yaya and go, wow, I should not do this because none of them are doing this, right? Okay, so you do have that conversation with yourself, I'm assuming.
Mm.
But then there's this. I'm going to die, though. Really? No, I'm serious. I'm not making a joke. It's, okay, fine. I can accept that they don't have yayas. Okay, but now what do I do? I can't get spaghetti. I will starve to death and die.
Oh, my
seriously.
God.
Because now you're talking about how will I function.
Oh, that's so sad.
I can't.
Yeah.
My regular pad will go unchanged for weeks. <It'll be laughs>
Let's not do this to the kids.
I'll put up with it. I want to hear some more.
No.
Good morning.
Hi. Good morning.
Oh, my gosh.
Hi. Oh, my gosh.
Oh, my
welcome
gosh.
To the show.
Hi.
Can you turn off your radio,
morning.
Please?
Hi.
Yeah, I went to an all-girls school,
and meron kami yung mga classmates na talagang rich. So, meron talaga silang staff. Meron silang driver, guard. Yeah. Eh, understandable. Wait, understandable naman kasi their parents are running international companies. So, di ba?
Ay, bodyguard levels.
Hindi ng parents.
The bodyguard I get, because if you're some kind of asset to a criminal or whatever, fine, I get it. I still don't think you need a staff for it. But what school did you go to?
All girls school in Makati.
Gotcha.
Named what?
What?
Named what?
Name what? Like what school? Seriously.
Red uniform. Come on, Mo.
I'm gonna go assume
CSA. What are we looking at?
Not all girls school.
Oh, that's not all girl. In
it's
Makati.
Only one all girls school in Makati with a red uniform.
Yeah.
Somebody,
I'm
Nico,
not,
what
I don't
who
know.
Cares?
Yeah, which one is
we're
this?
Not, we haven't named
Assumption,
any.
Assumption,
yes. Assumption is rich enough that they have to have security staff, personal.
I don't want
to
see the last name, diba?
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. And you're talking
like you sounded like half the class had it. You know, I went to this school. You know, the talaga nangyayari. And like it sounded like more than one.
I mean, hindi naman siguro half the class, pero evenly distributed in each section, talagang mga rich.
Wow.
I don't want to say the last name, pero
yeah, that's
eight.
Fine. I'm not asking. Okay.
And I mean,
right.
You're talking staff that's like hanging around the school.
Outside.
Yeah, just waiting for them to come
yeah.
out or whatever.
Kahit na yung village nila, next door lang din.
Ayos.
Diba? Kasi kasanto kami. So ano yung mga next door neighbors namin?
Sure.
Alright.
All
nandun lang naman
okay.
yung house nila, but their yaya guards and drivers should wait outside.
So it's usually a staff of three. There's a guard, a driver, and the yaya. All outside.
Siguro yung iba may backup cars pa.
Ew.
Wow.
And until now, because of course we're still friends on Facebook and Instagram. And you know that they're the same yayas from when we were in grade school. Are there yayas pa din until now?
Oh, okay. Props to them
for that.
Yeah, that's
kind of cute. That's sweet.
Thank you.
Yeah,
thank
and you see their posts na celebrating yaya ganyan.
Right.
Birthday.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-mm. Yep.
Thank you.
Right.
Thank you. Thank you against them kasi delikado nga naman if they don't have it. But they don't bring them around anymore.
Okay,
kasi
sure. Thank you.
Iba na hanggang ngayon nagmumol na may kasamang yaya.
How many times do I have?
Yeah. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Hindi, pero kasi ganito. Thanks. Bye. Bye.
Ooh, they're testing me today.
That was funny.
It's funny because, like, say you get your, you know, she said, like, some of them are super rich and then some of them are just the whatever, you know. So it's like the super rich is like, where's my stuff?
So
I'm like, oh, you're there. It's in your back. No, my stuff. It's like there's like four people. That's what I meant by stuff. Ah, kalakwa gamit. Okay. One last call, and then let's get out of here. Good morning.
Hello. Hey.
Yes, my ex-girlfriend was about 18, 19, and at that time, she still has her yaya with her all the time.
Would the yaya go on the dates with you?
There was, four occasions when it happened.
What?
Yep, first 4 days, I think. Yep,
wow.
And
wow.
She studied in USP, and she was living inside a dorm that was inside the school, but her yaya still goes there every day.
So when the yaya goes on the dates with you, right, what would your girlfriend ask her to do? Or would she just be kind of lurking in the background?
Noong first date, we were at Gateway. Talagang nandun siya the whole time. We weren't allowed na to a cinema, so we just... ape out.
Tapos nakinood din si Yaya, ganun?
Yep.
Libre mo din?
Actually, hindi ko naman libre.
Wow.
Pag nanonood si Yaya, may popcorn din siya.
Hindi ko na maalala. Hindi nga
remember
kami,
you said the Yaya meal version, remember?
The Yaya meal
version of popcorn.
Kaya nung later part, tumatakas kami. Yung pag alam niyang papunta na yung yaya niya doon sa, alis na kami from USP.
I wonder, like, you're in the film, right? You're watching the movie. It's all dark. And then you forget that the yaya is sitting on your left, not on your right. Then you go for the M5 with your hand.
Yeah, O-ring pala.
It's a little wrinklier than I thought. All right. Thanks for the call. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
No problem.
Bye. Bye.
Tough times. Man, I don't know. Am I jealous or am I thankful? I feel like I'm a little part of me is jealous.
No, you're not. No.
Come on.
No.
Take one day long. Take one day long, right? Don't you all want to just one day what that's like?
Not really.
No. Experience long.
Yeah, once.
No.
I won't have to bring a bag, Sam.
Ah. There's so many of them out there, too.
Yeah. Hey, because our lines are still full. That's crazy, right? Yeah. All right, never mind. Let's take a break. When we come back, more of the show. Don't go away.
From halfway across the globe, it's Mo Twister.
In Manila, it's Samo and Nico Ramos.
Good times.
Coldplay on this Tuesday morning at 7:45. Nico Ramos, speaking of Coldplay, what do you got, buddy?
That's right. The concert of 2017 is Coldplay, A Head Full of Dreams. It's coming our way, obviously, brought to us by MMI in partnership with Globe. But April 4th seems like it's so far away. So I know everybody wants to have a Coldplay experience already, and, you know, we're waiting already. So why don't we, get hooked up? Globe has got us hooked up with an awesome arsenal of events leading up to the concert of the year. The second drop of hashtag Globe Coldplay sessions are absolutely for free. You can jam to your favorite Coldplay songs covered by the coolest artists in the country on January 20. That's when the next leg will be, the 20th of January. That's a Friday at Bonifacio High Street and at the Bonifacio High Street Activity Center. It will be featuring Bullet Dumas, our good friend Janoy Danao, our other good friend Ebe Dancel, and Leanne and Nara, putting their own flavor to the songs you love. It's a festival of music in itself. Again, absolutely for free. And we'll be announcing the winners to the hashtag Globe Coldplay Project, where we ask you guys to create your own music video of your favorite Coldplay songs. If you sent an entry in, be sure to be there and drop by. Of course, anything Coldplay will always have to be a full-blown experience. That's why starting 11 in the morning that day, Globe has got us with awesome interactive activities that will go beyond music. So, with concert tickets officially selling out as early as December, get the chance to bring home very exciting surprises. That's all they're saying. Just by swinging by the event and hitting up the fun booths, it's an event you do not want to miss. Again, Bonifacio High Street Activity Center for hashtag Globe Coldplay Session 2, January 20th from 11 a.m. to 11 p.m. It's live, it's free, and it's Coldplay from the coolest artists on the block. See you there.
Thanks, Nick.
That's right.
Thanks, Globe.
We got hour number three coming up here in a bit. If you were not listening to our show yesterday, then you missed that it was Sam's birthday. So, Sam.
It was.
Belated.
It's my That's birthday awesome. Month.
37 Ew. Years young. I wanted to ask you this. Because remember that whole drama you had where you said, oh, these are the best years of your life, professionally, because you're with us?
Yeah.
You're welcome.
You're welcome, by the way, that
you
we bring so much.
You're such a dork. You bring this up all the time.
Yeah. Yeah. Well,
you're the dork. You almost were in tears saying it.
So I love you guys.
Guys, you know, I just have to say, ang dami kong achieved this sa career ko.
Ew, I didn't say that. I didn't open like that.
Bida ko sa ng isang channel. No. I just want to say this is the best time
Centerfold.
Of my life career.
Don't forget.
Yeah. Like FHM pa ako, all of that. It was really dramatic. And we appreciate that at 36, 37, 35, these are the best days of your life. I want to ask our listeners, 6310899, what was your best age? What was your greatest age? And let's try to take a poll of some kind and see, like, generally where the answers fall. Like, what's the average answer? Is it 28? Is it 25? Is it 35? What was the greatest age for you? Maybe tell us a little bit about it and then move on, and we'll try to get as many calls as we can. So 6310899, and let's see which number pops up the most.
Okay. Interesting. Yep. Yeah.
Okay. So Sam, let's start with you, though. We got calls. Okay, guys, hold on real quick. So professionally, you said this is the best time of your life.
Yes.
But what's your greatest age?
I'm trying to think back to a time where the hangovers were easiest. So maybe, like.
Really? You're basing your answer on goddamn alcohol?
I'm just kidding.
Yeah, yeah. Shut.
Yeah, I am drunk.
God, actually, I don't even know what criteria to work with, even.
Well, I mean, it depends on what kind of person you are. Some people will say, what the age that I was richest, or the age that I had the most chicks, or the age that I was the healthiest, had the abs. It really just depends on kind of what you value.
Yeah, I mean, because, like, I mean, I really like my life right now. You know,
yeah, you're welcome.
Thank
yes, you
Sam.
Guys are a big part of it.
Something to look forward to for me.
I'm healthy. I feel like I'm, you know, in really good shape health wise. And
you're dating a variety of listeners. I mean, it's good.
Yeah, that's right.
Fine, whatever. Professionally, I'm having a really good time. I mean, what more can I ask for? Seriously,
you've never looked better.
But is it the best? That's my question. Not is it great right now. We all have pretty good lives right now where we're at. But what's
I'm pretty close to saying yeah.
Yeah. Hey, good for you, Sammy. Good for you.
And it's all downhill from here, you know.
Yeah. Okay. You just set up for a bad 2017. So lines are full. Let's get to it. 6310899. Best year. I want the exact one, not a range. Okay. Let's go. Good morning.
Hello. Hello?
Hi,
I don't think my 30s were the best.
Paul. Age 32.
32.
With my son and the promotion at the same year.
Oh, wow.
That's a highlight year for sure.
32. Yeah. All right.
Thank you.
Well, thank you.
Yeah.
Bye-bye.
Thanks. Bye. 6310899. Nico, you are 27 years old. What is your greatest year?
Not 27.
No.
You just have a brand new girlfriend. Are you sure you want to rub that one in?
Not 27. That is for dang sure. This is not my best age. I'm happy though that both of the answers given so far are north of my age, so I have something to look forward to.
Is it because you're getting too injured now playing a game that you want to play every day? You love basketball. Now you can't play two games in a row without, you know, breaking something, and you come to work every morning, you're like, ugh.
But then I got these new pillows, man. I think basketball is a big factor to, because I was gonna say 2019 maybe. I was in college. I was playing for the team, practice every day, two games on weekends. I didn't mind.
And really, huh?
Wasn't terrible at it. Life was easier. Money. It was fine.
Okay.
What about you?
You were eating newspaper shomai.
But sure? I didn't know it was newspaper at the time. Yeah, ignorance is bliss, remember.
What about you, Mo?
I'm 39. I'd say 33.
Why?
Chicks.
Really? Really? Yeah,
it's variety.
My life is only beginning, thank you.
I mean,
there's probably more variety in that department.
Did something happen, like, particularly when you were 33?
Just, I guess, without complaining of current, like, I'm great, again, like, you know, the disclaimers has to be or else I get in trouble, right? But just, you know, it was, yeah, it's just like, yeah.
Was that the height of your, parang, dating life na, you know?
Was that when your commercial came out?
No, that was 20 years ago. Not really. It's not dating. It's just more like, wow, I feel, it felt more in demand in that category.
I met you when you were around this age.
And?
Is that right?
Yeah. No, Mo was.
Can you confirm?
Mo was balling. Yeah. You're living in Makati, wasn't it? Balling. Now Mo is biking.
Babysitting.
Okay, all right, fine. Shut up. Let's go. Go. Lights are full. So I'm going to write down 33. So far we have 32, 20, 33, and 37. So everything seems to be north of the 30s, except right. Nico is the one that screwed it up. Good morning.
Hi.
Oh, I'm not there yet.
Good morning. Belated happy birthday, Sam.
Thank you. Is this Kit?
Yeah.
Hey, Kit.
Around about the age, I think I was 25, and I have two ages. My current age and my 25, when I was 25.
And you're how old right now?
44,000 years old.
Let's go 25 then.
No, 25 because I had two children. I was married. I was starting my career at the time. There was a lot of traveling.
Uh-huh. And 44 because?
Because I can do whatever I want. The kids are big. I can run. I can bike. I can go. I can go out with friends.
You can have hot flashes.
No, not yet, Mo. You're so mean.
Not yet. Oh, that's why she still enjoys it. That's why she still enjoys it.
Not yet.
Yeah.
No, I like that because the middle period in between is raising kids, which seems like I can only assume is tough as balls. Yeah.
I think the 30s decade for women are tough because you have to come to terms with the decline, and then you have to find something that you embrace and become happy about again. So
yes.
You know, like,
wife.
Right? Well, because you know how you said 25, and I'm not surprised. I think a lot of females are going to call on the show and they're going to say 25. I think a lot of men are going to say in the 30s, because that 30s is peak earning power years for a guy and all that stuff. But when you hit the 30s as a female, you have to be strong, I think, in the mind to fight that, oh, my God, I'm starting to sag a little more. I'm starting to my pores are starting to show. You know, little stupid things like that.
Oh, no, but
and then when you get past that, it's great. So that's why you can say 44.
If you have the confidence, I think, if you have good genes, you take care of yourself. It's going to pay off.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Sure. All right.
Thank you, Kit.
All right. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye.
You too. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Yeah, yeah, Sam, and you're that kind of girl that I'm saying. Like, you're strong, so you can not think of it as a decline. It's just like, okay, whatever.
It's right, fine. I mean, you know, it's
starting a chapter.
It's a completely natural thing. And yes, I think every woman, you know, kind of struggles with that a little bit. And then, yeah, it just depends entirely on you, how you come out at the other end of that.
That'll dictate how great your 40s are.
Yes, yes.
Because they can be great.
And do like take care of yourself. Please, yeah.
Yes. Yeah. In other words, don't get fat. Good morning.
Hi. Good morning. Hello.
Hello. Oi. Next call.
So much class. Hi. Good morning.
Hello. Good morning.
Hey.
Hi.
So for me, I would say it has to be 32.
32. Okay.
Yeah. So
are you a boy or girl?
This is a woman.
It's a girl? Okay, no,
yes.
Sorry.
Excuse him.
I was in the peak of my career. I can have money. I can travel. I would go wherever I want. I would do whatever I want. So it's just great.
Mm. Yeah, 32 is a great age. Yeah.
You married?
No.
How old are you now?
33.
Oh, okay. So you're still around that neighborhood.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think maybe not being married is because now this is a guy answer. All of a sudden, you're not married, you don't have kids, so you don't have that obligation in your 30s. Well, a lot of women do because, you know, they feel they start to panic in their late 20s, right, regarding their clock and whatnot. So because you don't have that issue, now you're living a, I don't want to say a guy's life because that sounds kind of rude, like saying that guys have better lives. But, you know, you gave a guy answer, the 30s, because now you're independent, you can do things, you've got money to do things.
Not really, because I have a daughter, see.
Oh, do you?
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
So okay.
You just get all of that. You have the independence. You can do whatever it is that you want. But also, well, now, because I had my daughter last year, so it's also having her. And you have that obligation still, yes, but you still get that independence. And you have you basically can make your own decisions and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah.
Thanks. Thanks for the call. Appreciate it.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
So we have 7 phone calls. We have 7 different answers. Not one was the same. The average age of best ever, 30.4. Or if Tom Rodriguez was here, 3.14.
Something to look forward to.
30.4. In other words, 9 years ago.
Oh my gosh, Nick, you are. I mean, your best years are yet to come, really.
Yeah,
it's gonna get so much.
Yeah, you got to come out of the closet in the next year, and then after that, it just really starts pumping up.
If my ACL doesn't give out by then, yeah,
yeah,
my best years are ahead.
I mean,
6310899. We're talking about what's your greatest age ever? And you know, again, we're taking a little bit of a poll here. Give us a number. Tell us a little bit why, and then we'll try to come out with some kind of. Average here a little bit later. Sorry, Sam, you were saying.
No. I forgot now. Hi, good morning.
Hi, sorry.
Hello.
Good morning.
Hi, sorry.
Thanks, Mo. That's the age. That's 37. Kanina lang. By the way, before this topic started, Nico was giving you that Coldplay thing, right?
Yeah.
I sent a message to Sam. What's our topic again? And she's like, "Hey, gotta go age." I go, "Oh,
hi." Hello.
Hi, Sam. Happy
birthday. Hi. Thank you.
26.
26?
26.
Yeah.
Why?
When I was 26, it's my first travel abroad, mm-hmm. and it's European travel. 3 European countries.
My budget.
Wow. Okay. Big time.
Nag-edihelya ka ba with a Euro girl there?
No.
Mm.
Oh, so, okay.
So that's my first travel abroad, and I just turned 27 this January 7th.
Oh, happy
that's
birthday
why.
To you, too.
Don't worry. It gets better.
Yeah.
It gets better. Yeah.
So much better.
Yeah.
All right. Thanks,
okay,
man.
Thank
appreciate
you.
It.
Bye-bye.
Now I'm trying to break down Nico's answer of 19, 20.
20.
Because yours by far is the youngest answer. And, well, you're probably the youngest caller along with that guy. Or youngest contributor, huh?
But, you know, I'm going to bring it back to what you said earlier. It's really about what you value. Nico, obviously, is all about, like, peak physical performance.
Yeah, but that's 27.
Life, bro.
No. But you're the, you know, in sports, 27. That is your, that's your prime, right?
Yeah. If, but you I know, mean, I didn't tear my quad.
Physically, though, like, yeah. I mean, aren't you better at 20 than when you are when you're 27?
No.
Oh no. Like
no. When you're 27, like, you're the best.
Like skills wise, since you know I never really stopped playing, I like my 27-year-old self could beat my 20-year-old self. It's just the fatigue and the health and
yeah.
The not caring about money and being on campus and
eating newspaper.
The student life.
Yeah.
All right. Let's keep it going.
I had a good
631-3899.
Good
morning.
Yeah.
what was his name?
Hi, good morning.
Hi.
Yeah, I guess my best age is 18.
18? Oh, even younger.
Yeah.
Why?
This is why I've had multiple chicks. I can still reach the ring during that time. I play basketball, that's why.
How old are you now?
29.
29, and you can't even tap board anymore, huh?
Yeah.
What's the weight difference between 18-year-old you and 29-year-old you?
20
pounds?
20 kilo.
20 kilos.
Ooh. Okay, so it's a fat thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, but aren't you got a lot of money now, right, compared to those days?
Well, I've had I was a working student back then, so. And I was working on a call center, and I've had a lot of money as compared to my, you know, my my other students or student mates, my classmates. So I've had more money than them. I guess that's the peak.
Yeah. Okay.
All righty.
All right.
Embrace the 30s. It's gonna be great, especially when you have a little bit more money.
Yeah.
Thanks for the call.
Yeah.
Thank you. Bye bye.
Bye.
Multiple chicks.
Are you looking forward to your 40s, Mo?
Oh, no.
What? You know what they say, life starts at 40.
How old do people think you are in the U.S.?
Oh, like early, maybe late 20s, early 30s. Early 30s.
Yeah, so, you know.
No, but I'm tiny, I'm small.
Right, it's not that bad.
Yeah, but still, doesn't change.
I mean, you feel it.
Yeah. Let's take another call here. Good morning.
Hello.
Hi.
Candy!
Candy's been itching to get on the show with all these topics we've had. Yeah. Hi,
first
Candy.
27 to 3, because I was done with med school.
You were done
give
with
me a
med
number.
School?
Give me a number. Don't give me a range.
27.
Okay.
27. And then I think the next will be when I'm 55, when my kids are big already.
Mm. Hot flash.
Hi, Anton.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, okay.
27.
Yeah, 27
is good.
Got
it. Were you trying to call with our Yaya topic? I'm sure you were, right?
I didn't want to because you're just going to make fun of my comments.
Yeah.
You know, Candy's kids don't have a Yaya.
Yep.
Okay, but how old were you? How long did you have a Yaya till? Come on now, be honest.
Okay, till I was married.
Jesus Christ.
As in, she was, like she was following you around? Yung ganung tipong Yaya?
Yaya, hindi may regla pad, ganun?
When I take a shower, she has to be outside.
Candy,
yes, and
God.
I can't tie my shoelace till now.
Candy!
Oh, till now?
No.
Till now?
Yes,
who ties
I can.
Your shoes now?
Pardon?
Who ties your shoe right now?
I don't wear rubber shoes.
Because you can't tie the laces?
Well, I wear it in the gym, and that's pretty much
who
it.
Ties
if
it?
I tie. If I tie it, it cannot get off. I'm in the
so
gym.
You, like, quadruple tie it so it doesn't...
Candy, oh Candy,
you know,
you're a dermatologist.
Easy.
I'm sure you can figure it out.
I
come on, girl.
Don't even say dermatologist. You're a doctor.
Come
I mean, like, you
on,
went
girl.
To medical school.
I was able to for a while, but I just can't do it anymore.
What do you mean you can't do it anymore?
Because maybe I don't wear rubber shoes that much, so there's not much practice. I mean, I just have to tie it once when I go to the gym, and then I just have to slip it on that knot doesn't come off.
It's the muscle memory. She doesn't have the muscle memory for it.
The hell.
That's why I'm raising my kids differently. I'm correcting it.
Good on you. Good on you.
Yep.
Yeah.
Happy birthday, Sam.
Thank you so much.
Okay, bye.
Bye, Candy.
Bye, Candy.
This is the only time I wanted Candy to stay on here.
I still love you, Candy.
Average age, 28.4 now is the answer so far.
That's me.
Come on, guys.
Come on, guys.
3 months.
Let's go, everybody. Call on the show. Call the show. Come on.
Pressure, guys. Bump that, pressure.
Bump
pressure.
Those numbers up. Let's pressure. Get it up. Come on.
Pressure.
Come on.
Hi.
Morning.
Hi. Good morning.
Good morning.
Yeah, I just want to share the age. For me, it's like 31.
Yeah.
Because this was the time that I really broke out of my shell, and I started dating with somebody who I just met on the way home from the airport from Oahu. And then he is
did
like...
Did you say Oahu?
Oahu, yeah. That's a little name.
Honolulu. Like
yeah.
Hawaii?
A little name drop of I went to Hawaii. Okay, go ahead.
Yeah,
it's in Hawaii then because I just met him there. And then all of he was really very good looking because he was part a designer of... Of Marie Claire.
Yeah.
From Marie Claire in Europe. And then we had a really nice time talking over coffee. And then all of a sudden, the following month, he flew to Manila.
Ooh.
Yep.
And we met up. And that's it. That's something like something
what's
very
your name?
Unforgettable. Carrie.
Oh, it's Carrie.
Carrie.
Very bad colds today.
Yeah. Well, how many colds?
I don't notice. I didn't notice. You sound fantastic as usual.
Oh, thank you. So that's it. Something like I don't usually talk to anybody when I'm out of the country or wherever I go, unless it's really very professional. But then this guy, but he was really very good looking. He was really very good looking.
So your greatest moment of your entire existence is based on this one dude from Manila.
Yeah, for now.
All right.
How long ago was this?
This was like 31. It was like 4 years. 4 years ago, yeah.
All right.
Mm. Okay. When you were still growing up in the hood of Malabon, right? Thanks for the call, baby. Appreciate
it. Thank you.
Call every day.
How long? How many years ago was she abroad? Was it 2 years? 3 years?
2 years. 2 years.
2 years.
2 years. Yeah. Wasn't she in Australia?
That's my thinking sip. Yeah, she was in Australia. Can't you tell?
I don't know where that. I don't know what that accent is.
Let's take another
call. I have
here.
No idea.
Good morning.
Hi.
Hi, good morning.
Good morning.
Hi, Sam. Happy birthday.
Thank you.
We have a poll. What's your greatest age?
Yeah. 26.
26?
26, yeah.
Why?
Don't get me wrong. I'm happy right now. I have two kids. I think 26 is the best adventurous in terms of being adventurous. So before you were not afraid to take, the high rides. I didn't get to travel much, but I feel that I matured back then, but still okay for, younger girls back then. But that's it.
All right. Thanks, man.
Thank
Appreciate
you.
It.
All right. Thanks.
Bye.
We're still at 28.4.
That really puts pressure on me. I turned 28 in April.
No, and the reason why I feel bad about it is because, now it puts me over a decade away.
It just becomes, farther and farther away.
Like,
from
I already know it's in the past, right? I already know. I've accepted that. But does it have to be so far?
Okay, maybe now I'm excited. I'm 3 months away from the best time of my life.
And if it's not amazing, you're screwed.
I know. My expectations are way too high.
It's 8:07 here. We're talking about what age was the greatest age of your life, and we're trying to calculate all this and come up with some average. Boy, girl, doesn't matter. Good morning.
Hello. Hi.
Hi, good morning.
Hey.
Hey.
Yeah. I think 27.
What happened when you were 27?
That's the first time that I got a job.
Mm.
Yeah, but
and you like your first job that much that 27 sticks out as your best year.
Well, it depends how old are you right now.
No, but before I felt that hindi na ako magkaka SSS because I can't even get a job.
How old are you, Ngaba, now?
I'm 32. Yeah.
Mm. See, that's why. Yeah, okay. Yeah. All right. Okay.
Thank you.
Bye. Yes, I know all you scientists on the listening show, our formula's flawed. I know. Shut up. Moving on. Because he can't say 34 because he's still younger than that.
Oh, so right.
Our formula sucks, but it's okay. We'll still take it.
Yeah.
Morning.
Hi. Good morning. Hello.
Hi. Morning.
Hey.
Hi. Good morning.
This is Bernadette.
Hey, Bernadette.
Hi, Bernadette. What's up?
Yeah. Age was 33 last year.
Mm-hmm. 33?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Why is that?
Yeah, I got promoted and I started paying for my own house.
Ooh.
Look at you, Bernadette.
Milestone.
Look at you.
Yeah.
Yeah. Congrats.
Thanks.
Yeah. All right. You have a boyfriend?
None as of this time.
Yeah. Okay.
Own house.
How long
no
have you been
man.
Single?
6 months.
Oh.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Good.
Not
nice.
Long. Yeah. You okay?
Yeah.
Okay. Good. All right.
Yep. Thanks.
Thank you.
Good
Thanks
time.
For calling. Bye.
33.
Wonder, was she so heartbroken that she bought that house? You think?
It sounds like it. That's
what it
sounds like.
I don't need you, man, in my life. Watch me buy my own house, asshole. Right? That's what I heard.
I mean, what a positive way to, you know, use that.
Oh, yeah,
anger
no, absolutely.
And rage or whatever. Yeah.
Yeah.
Good for her.
Yeah, good. One last call. Let's get out. Good morning.
Hi.
Hello.
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 Hi.
Hi, good morning.
Good morning.
Morning.
For me, it's 26.
Okay.
Okay, because financially wise, my salary was that time was already comfortable for me.
At 26, huh? Continue, please.
I'm sorry?
It's okay. And then?
All right. And then also socially speaking, that time I can party all night, every day,
yeah,
and my body can still cope up.
You make it Sam feel bad.
Di ka tumataba.
Ay, totoo. Totoo yan. The metabolism. Oh my gosh, I miss my metabolism. Yes.
I miss drugs.
I can't sleep. I can stay up all day without sleep. And then when it comes to love life, I mean, even if I have a boyfriend that time, I can still date other guys. I mean, you know, I'm still single, so I'm just enjoying my life. So there.
Great.
How old are you?
I'm 36 now.
Yeah.
So that was 10 years ago. Mm-hmm. That's why until now I still feel I'm 26. I'm only 26.
Yeah, you're lying to yourself. All right. Okay. Thanks, sweetheart.
Thank
you're caller 15.
Thank you, guys.
Bye.
Yeah.
Bye.
That was 15 calls, 28.4, Nico Ramos.
Oof.
This is it. This is your year, Nick.
My year.
Woo-hoo.
So your best, the best time of your life. When did you say your birthday was? 3 months from now?
April 1.
April Fool's Day.
Oh, that's right. April 1. So let's. So what's the point four there on April? Would be like December? November would be the greatest. Should be. By this November. Should be the greatest time of your life.
Peak,
right?
Dude. Peak.
November, December.
Can't wait.
Yeah.
Can't wait.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I'm going to try to ruin it for you. out of jealousy.
Yung 27 ko, sinira mo na.
I'm going to ruin it.
Sinira mo na yung 27 ko, ah. Not once, not twice. Leave my 28s alone.
Just wait.
All right, let's take November.
Let's take a break. When we come back, we have more of the show. Don't go away.
From halfway across the globe, it's Mo Twister.
In Manila, it's Sam Mo and Nico Ramos.
Good times. 89.9.
For 17 days this January, get ready to rev it up with Caltex. Zoom straight to 2 select Caltex stations per day and get a thrilling 7 peso discount per liter every 10 to 11 a.m. and 3 to 4 p.m. only. But pit stop first on our Facebook page for the next Caltex stations where you can rev it up. It's pedal to the metal to make it to the station. And it is go for the jeepney. Enjoy the journey this 2017 with Caltex. Promo run. runs from January 4 to 20, 2017. Per DTI FTEB permit number 16102, series of 2016.
Ang saya ng barkada, i-share mo na, i-share mo na.
Ganyan.
Selfie, groupie, MP.
Uy, saya niya na.
Share with everybody, celebration, promotion, at sa bawat okasyon.
Hashtag na gumpay.
Share na ang sarap ng Emperador Life.
Sarap.
Emperador Light, i-share mo na, tagumpay ay lalong sasaya. Emperador Light, gawin mong night.
Drink responsibly.
Sa bawat okasyon, i-share with everybody ang sarap ng Emperador Light. Hashtag EMFI. Hashtag tagumpay. Gawin mong light. With Emperador Light. Drink responsibly.
Download, 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 download.
Buying and selling basketball gear is made easier with the all-new OLX app. Download it now on the App Store and Google Play.
Down, 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 download, down, download, download the OLX app.
Finding wedding gifts and items is made easier with the all-new OLX app. Download it now on the app.
You know, some of the answers earlier were like chicks, variety, yeah. Multiple chicks, right? As the that can also be a headache for many people. And I want to kind of jump into our next topic here is people who have had multiple relationships, you know, like the other party didn't know, cheating basically. But relationships, you had multiple. I wonder how long somebody can carry that, you know?
Have you, I mean, either of you, no, never?
I think we've all cheated, but carried two simultaneous relationships,
yeah,
like
never?
Real ones. No, I don't think so.
Like two girlfriends?
No. Yeah.
Yeah, you had two girlfriends.
Who
at the same
would want
time.
That headache?
Short term's awesome, long term headache. Yeah. Huh. 631-0899. What's the longest, I guess, the longest time you carried two relationships?
Okay. Yeah, our listeners
like
come to.
How many of you guys can pull it off?
Yeah, our listeners come to us and tell us all the time how they're doing this right now.
Yeah,
so
they volunteer the information.
Exactly.
Right, so, okay, we already know you're a dick or you're an ass or you're a bitch or whatever like that if you have two relationships. Okay, so let's get that out of the way. We're not going to say you're a bad person. We've already said it. Now we have to admire how you're able to pull it off.
And how long you've been able to pull it off.
Yeah, because that's big time, man. You ninja. Like, that's espionage levels. Like, you're a spy. If you could pull that off, you could pull 2-3 relationships off for X amount of months or years without them knowing. That's kind of hardcore.
And look at that. Our lines are filling up.
What a shocker. Good morning.
Hi.
Next.
Hello.
Morning.
Hello. Good morning.
Hi.
Hey.
Yeah. It's not me, actually. It's my friend. It's my best friend. Mm-hmm. He was in a relationship for 8 years with two girls.
8 years?
8 years?
Yeah.
Oh, Lord.
High school and college, huh?
Yeah. Actually, it's college and after graduating. But now he's married.
To one of them?
With another one because she got her pregnant.
Oh, he's going to cheat on
man,
her.
Oh, man.
Oh,
he's cheating already. He's cheating
already.
Yeah, pero... Sinabi niya kasi na panata niya yon na magkaanak lang siya, titigil na siya. So kahit kanino ba.
Oh, that's baloney.
He's still cheating, isn't he?
No. But I mean, I'm really curious. As far as you can tell, is he faithful now?
Yeah, so faithful that sinusundo siya ng asawa niya pag nagiinuman and wala siyang reklamo, umuwi lang siya.
That's not when he's cheating. That's fine.
Yeah, that's it. So, good times.
The fact that the wife is picking up, it's because he has cheated, you see.
maybe.
That's
so.
Why she's picking him up, because it's like, oh, you're going to go out drinking. Okay, well, you know what? I'm picking you up so you don't find your way back from the motmot to the house.
Ay, baka kasi alam niya yung history.
Yeah, but being the best friend, I know that he really changed, so I don't know why.
Oh, good. Good.
All right.
Yeah.
Thanks, man. Appreciate
Thank
it.
You.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Bye-bye.
Thank you. 631-0899. What's the longest amount of time you were able to carry multiple relationships? It doesn't even have to be two. It could be like four. Good morning.
Hi.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
Yes. 10 years and still counting.
What?
Ten years and still counting?
Oi.
How many?
Oh, oi.
I think it's a burden. Like it was a responsibility that fell in your lap, right?
They're both.
How many? Two?
Yeah. Two to three.
Hmm? Three?
I guess two. Yung isa irregular.
Oh yeah, I'm a FUBU style.
Are they both
Ten
girlfriends?
Years.
Are they both girlfriends or asawa mo yung isa?
Yeah. Good. Hindi.
Girlfriends.
Okay. How do you distribute your week?
Wala yun. Ano, scheduled lang.
Parang hindi
niya plano eh.
All right, get off our show. Get off.
What? Next Why?
It's so difficult to answer. Just asking simple questions.
The exchange is a little. Thank you.
Yeah,
good luck with that. 10 years. My gosh.
Sayang. It's a good answer.
Oma.
Just the guy's so difficult to work with. Good morning.
Hi.
I'm breaking up with you. Something your girlfriend should have done.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Hello. Oh, 3 years.
Can you turn off your radio, please?
Wife and girlfriend, or girlfriend and girlfriend, or girlfriend and boyfriend?
Girlfriend, tatlo. Isa nasa abroad.
Three, tatlo?
That's easier.
Yung isa
dito, easy.
Manila.
Pero tatlo.
It's not that hard, then?
Hindi, madali lang. Kasi hindi mo naman makikita yung isa.
Yep.
Mga isa Skype, ano lang. Skype lang. Yung isa naman, pag-uwi ka lang probinsya.
Yep. Do you know if they're cheating on you?
Hindi naman nila alam, eh.
Yeah, but do you think they're cheating on you? Because they're long distance, too.
Okay lang din, kasi ginagawa ko naman eh.
Yeah, love it.
Oo, kumbaga, ano lang.
Quits, ganun?
Quits lang. Ganun lang, syempre. Kung ano kaya ng babae, ganun din, kaya ng lalaki. So, hindi ka pwedeng magalit.
Do you love any of them?
Hindi.
Oh, wow. Like, not even one of them?
Well, sabi mo na meron siguro, pero kumbaga hindi talaga para ipasalan mo pa isa sa kanila.
So, ano yung purpose ng tatlo? Bakit kailangan mo ng tatlo?
That's a good question. For you, what's your personal...
Like, dumating lang naman what do you din gain? Eh. Kumbaga hindi mo naman masabi, isa dumating. O, nag-okay kayo, so okay. Diba? Kasi magbayad ka for...
Pero, you know what? Ka, you know what, this guy is kind of, it's like, it's almost eerily loyal. Right? You're really interesting because you're like, okay, so why do you have three girlfriends? Oh, because I said so. So you're so loyal to the decision that you're cheating on loyalty. I love it. You're cool, man.
Saka hindi ka pa naman magsiseryoso. So wala ka namang asawa, so walang karma yon. Sana.
Yeah, well,
ay, meron yun.
Pero siguro mas masama pag may asawa ka. At no, girlfriend lang naman. Siguro, kumbaga sa ano, para ka naglalaro ng apoy. Pag napaso ka, may gamutin.
Whatever helps you sleep better.
Never ka pa, I mean, it sounds as if you've always been cheating since forever. Never ka pa nahuli.
Hindi talaga eh. Kasi kailangan mo maingat ka rin. So, pag isang girlfriend mo, isang phone gamit mo, pag isang gamit mo.
Like on Facebook mo.
Have you ever been in just one committed relationship?
Siguro before, pero nung ano, naisip ko, sayang kung mag-iisa ka lang, bata ka pa. So, enjoy muna, di ba?
How old are you?
Oh nga, you sound a little mature.
Ay, oh, yun yung time siguro ng mga sa 30s ka.
Pero ngayon, ilang taon ka na ngayon?
Ay, mag-40 na ako.
Oy!
So there's a chance. Yeah, okay. Alright.
Oh, ngayon medyo ano na. Ngayon hindi na. Ngayon, kung mag-cheat ka, siguro bayad na lang. Para walang feelings.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, you pay na lang, you pay. Wala nang ligaw-ligaw kasi mas masumayan eh.
Yeah, okay. Thanks, sir.
Thank you.
Good call.
Thank you.
Good call.
Bye.
Question is, what's the longest time you carry two relationships? Or, sorry, multiple relationships. Like, I had three girlfriends 2 years now, right? I think he said.
Three girlfriends for 3 years.
So you're saying there's a chance.
Sorry, hold on. I know that this is off topic. Christian here on Twitter says, Regarding your topic kanina, I guess it's happening right now. He's sitting next to a girl in school, and his her yaya is combing her hair in class. Yeah, it's right now, as we speak. May katabi akong girl ngayon na sinusuklay pa ng yaya right now in college.
Oh my gosh.
As we speak.
Wow.
What topic were we doing? Okay, here we go. 6310899, longest time you carried multiple relationships. Good morning.
Hello.
Good morning. Longest time, 2 years, but four girlfriends? Back when I was in college.
Oh gosh.
Four.
I ran away from home.
Oh.
So I needed to survive. So parang sila yung financer.
Ah, wow. You're living off of them. Smart. Smart.
By schedule, since hindi naman sila nagche-check ng phone and hindi naman ako masyadong active sa Facebook.
Are you talking into an electric fan?
Stand away from the electric fan,
I was able
sir.
To survive.
Pero off of cheating. I love it. Yeah, it's okay. You got what you needed. All right. Thanks, man. Appreciate it.
Thank
good
you.
Call.
Bye-bye.
That's interesting. Imagine he's like, for a guy to be able to pull that off.
And because, I mean, it doesn't, he didn't have money, right? I mean, so it sounds to me like the girls had to be in one place. Meaning, hindi sila out of town, yung isa nasa ibang bansa or whatever.
That's right.
Like, they're all kind of near each other.
Right, right.
That is intense.
Those are four ugly chicks, dude.
But wow. 2 years he did that. Damn.
Yeah. Hey, gotta envy that. Quick announcement before we take one last call.
Yes. This is about the Caltex Rev Up promo, which is happening today. You're probably wondering where it's going to be. It's going to be at Caltex Ninoy Aquino, Kabihasnan, Parañaque. If you head there today, you're going to get 7 pesos off of every liter of fuel. This is happening from 10 to 11 this morning, but people start, you know, going there very early on. So you want to head there right now. Again, it's at Caltex Ninoy Aquino Kabihasnan in Parañaque. It's called the Caltex Rev Up Promo. Good luck.
6310899. We have time maybe for one more call, so let's get to it. Good morning.
Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
I'm calling for my friend. Sabi niya, ano, 1 year, 3 relationships. And then 2 relationships, 3 years. The key daw is hello.
Yeah.
Yes.
We have not left you.
The key daw is for the number 2 to know about the number 1 and then the number 3 to know about the number 2 and number 1.
Ay, parang pumapyramid siya.
Like
that made sense
marketing.
In my head, sorry.
Yeah.
No, I guess. So, but one can't know about 2 or 3, but 2 knows about 1 and 3 knows about 2 and 1.
Yeah. And then, yung mahirap daw yung nangyayari kay Mo dati na sa isang araw, tatlo. So, kaya tinigil niya na raw.
Ikaw pala eh.
What?
So, ako yung inspiration. Thank you. That's right. Hey, guess what? That happened in my greatest year of my greatest age of my life. Okay. Yeah, thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye.
So funny because off air right now, our boss, our station manager, he's doing the same exact math as that guy was just doing right now. He was like, "Did I hear that right? Your best age was 30, so 7 years ago." Then he starts breaking down all of these other females, and I'm like, "Hey, I'm on the air. Relax. Stop bothering us." Till this very second, now he just sent us, "Ha ha ha, boss, we're on the radio.
Station,
let us do our jobs."
Station guys got your history, man.
Yeah, no, he's doing the math right now. He's like, I'm going to get to the bottom of this.
So see, anyun.
It is a Tuesday morning here. We will take a commercial break. When we come back, we have more of the show. Don't go away.
From halfway across the globe, it's Mo Twister.
In Manila, it's Samo and Nico Ramos.
Good times.
Mahal. Withdraw lang ako.
Your balance is only 50 pesos. Please take your card.
Di
lahat ng masarap, mahal. Kapit lang! Sa Jollibee, may Jolly Savers. Yum Burger, 33. Jolly Spaghetti, 50. Burger Steak, 50. Kita. Sa Jolly Savers, sarap payday sa presyong everyday.
Right. That's right.
Yeah, we never say Debbie's name. Why is that?
Woman
we
Debbie
should.
Are up next.
They're a duo, you know.
Yeah. Come on, Tyler. We'll see you guys tomorrow. Have a good day. Thanks for joining us. Thanks for calling. We appreciate it. And
love
yeah.
you. See you. Bye, then. Guys.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Brand new year.
Same glorious audio. We all need. We all need. Magic 89.9.
Kaya mo bang tumagal ng 3 days without rice?
Kaya!
Hello, delivery. Order ng isang bucket ng chicken. No rice.
Walang ligo.
Kaya! Yaya, ihanda ang isang kilong tawas.
Eh, no text call setups.
Ha? Huh? Oh, hindi!
Chill! Dahil may TNT Super Combo 30. May only text to all. 100 minutes of calls to TNT, Smart and Sun, and 100 MB of babad apps like FB and COC. 30 pesos lang for 3 days of Tropa connections.
TNT! It's a Tropa thing!
Text SC30 to 4545. Promo runs until March 31, 2017. For DTI FTEB SPD permit number 15463, series of 2016.
Ayun tayo sa masarap.
Mahal. Withdraw lang ako.
Your balance is only 50 pesos. Please take your card.
Kung wala ka nang makapitan.
Di lahat ng masarap, mahal. Kapit lang! Sa Jollibee, may Jolly Savers. Yum Burger, 33. Jolly Spaghetti, 50. Burger Steak, 50.
Hindi kita.
Sa Jolly Savers, sarap payday sa presyong everyday.
Kapos na ba sa budget? Kapit lang. Sa Jollibee, may Jolly Savers for only 50 pesos and below. Sarap payday every day.
Get a free world traveler luggage when you apply for a Cebu Pacific Get-Go credit card by Union Bank. To join, simply apply before February 28, 2017 and use your new credit card for a minimum accumulated purchase of 30,000 pesos until May 31, 2017. Visit getgo.unionbankph.com today. Terms and conditions apply. For DTI FTB permit number 16144, series of 2016.
This year, we've got what you need.
24-karat magic in the air.
To start the year right, we've got the hits.
We've got your favorite DJs.
We've got the best content. Locally,
digitally, globally, absolutely.
We've got everything you need.
Everything you need.
In one radio station. This 2017, we all need magic.
The more I want to, something inside me's changed. I was so much younger yesterday.